So now we've got this this page that kind of looks okay, but the text is small and the images, there's lots of empty space around the images and not too much going on, just the HTML, no CSS. Now we're gonna, you know, design it using the CSS and talking to all the tags we have, the H1 tag and the body tag for the whole background color, the image tag, the paragraph tag. We're gonna design this thing right now. So let me go, there we go. There's my text wrangler. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna talk to the body. And again, the body tag is one of those tags we can talk to right there. And we're gonna tell it to have a background color. So background, colon, and then a number sign. And I'm gonna save it, go Command S, keep saving. And I'm gonna go into Color Lovers, and I found a palette that I'm gonna try here. Let's see, so let's do, which one do I want here? Here's my hex number. So in Color Lovers, it's this hex number that you want. It's a 6-digit letter number combination. Sometimes all letters, sometimes both. And if you highlight this and put a number sign in front of it, it means something to the computer, and thus it shows it on a web page. Now you have to have a number sign before it to let the computer know to read that number. But I've done that. I copied it. I put a semicolon at the end. Again, you want to watch out. You always want to have semicolons in your CSS. That tells the computer you're done with that line of code and to read it. So I'm going to save it, and let's just see. Where is that at here? There we go. Is it working? Okay. Gotta find out why that's not. Oh, okay. Because I'm not talking to the body tag. I'm saying, I need to say, hey, computer, I have a body tag down there, and I have the curly brackets. And then I have to close the curly bracket off. And then I put things in between the curly brackets. So here's the tag that I want to talk to. Now notice there are no angle brackets like down here. This is the HTML. This is the CSS. So I tell what tag I want to do. I have an open curly bracket and a closed curly bracket. And in between, we do a laundry list of stuff to change the look of that tag on our page. So let me try this again. There we go. Okay. So now I'm going to grab, that was for the body. Let me try this. I'm going to copy this plummy. And again, go back into my coding. And I'm going to talk to the H1 tag right here and design it. And I'm going to say, hey, computer, I have an H1 tag down there, a curly bracket. I always like to open and close curly brackets before. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to say, to change the color of text, you just say color. So color, colon, the two dots, number sign, and then I'm going to paste that hexadecimal color number. Okay? And there's another thing I want to do. I want to change the look of the text. I want to change the font size. I'll say 44 px. PX stands for pixel, and that's an increment of size, very small. And I'm also going to change the font-family. That's the type of font or type of text that it is. And I'm going to say, let's see here. I think that's a font. Let me go ahead and turn it. All right. So now what I'm going to do is let me do that again. Font-size colon 44px, and then font-family colon. Let's do Georgia. Okay. And again, I'm going to save it. I can click right here. It'll show me where it is. I'll double click in and open it. And there's our new H1 right there. Okay. Now, the other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go and I'm going to talk to the paragraph tag. So I'm going to say, hey, computer, I got a P tag down there. I got some P tags. And here's what I want to do. Let's say font-size. And let's give it a font-size of 14. We can do PT. That's this thing. It's what Word uses for size. And then let's also indent the first line of our paragraphs. We're going to say text-indent. And let's indent it by 60px. Okay. So there. Our text has gotten bigger. It's been indented right here in the first lines of our paragraph. Okay. The next thing I'm going to do is let's, I guess we can keep that color. Let me go back into this. Let's say color, number sign 222. That's a dark charcoal. I don't know if you can tell that color or not. In fact, let's make it a little bit bigger here. I'm going to go 16 PT. Just a little bit. Okay, now here's the big one we're going to do. We are going to give class names to each one of these images so the computer will recognize them separately. Because one, we're going to move left, the other one we're going to move right, and then maybe back to the left and right, and kind of fill up the page like that. So how we do that is, we're going to go down here, and I'm going to work inside the angle brackets right here. I'm going to put my cursor just past that quotation mark. Notice it's still inside the closing angle bracket. I'm going to hit the space bar. I'm going to say class equals 1. We're going to give it a name of 1. So now from now on, the computer will recognize this image as the word 1. I'm going to do the same thing down here. Hit the space bar, class equals 2. So again, this tree 2 will be known to the computer in the coding as the word 2. Okay, let's keep going. Hit the space bar, class equals 3. Class equals 4. And class equals 5. Okay? So again, we haven't done anything to them yet, but we're setting up. And we're going to talk to these words that we called them. We gave them, basically gave them an association, what's called a class name. So to talk to a class name in CSS, we're going to use the period before the name. So I'm going to go up, you know, here in between the style. Here's my closing style tag. I'm going to go up above that, and I'm going to say the period and the word that I called the first one, and then the angle bracket, I mean in the curly brackets, just like that. And what we're going to do is, we're going to do a couple things to these. We're going to float this first image left. And what's that going to do is it's going to clear up all this empty space here, and this paragraph underneath it will come up here and go in the empty space. And you'll have paragraphs of Latin text wrapped around the image. Okay? So I just did that, float left. Oh, maybe I gotta save it. I don't think I saved it. There. Now notice how tight the paragraph is around the image. Let's make the image breathe a little bit and give it some space so the paragraph isn't up against it right there. We're going to give it what's called padding. And so padding is going to open up empty space around the image to let it breathe a little bit. So I'm going to go back to my coding. I'm going to add a line, a laundry list in between the curly brackets. I'm going to say padding, P-A-D-D-I-N-G, colon, let's say 20 px. And that's going to be on all sides, the top, the right, the bottom, and the left. And I'm going to save it and reload. And now you'll see that there's empty space around the image. Now, if we want, we could give a border and have a background color and give it some color to that if we wanted to. Let me show you how to do that. I am going to move this down a little bit. Let me get out of here. I'm going to go and let's make this our border. I think I copy that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to say background and a number sign, and then I'm going to paste that hexadecimal color number and do a semicolon at the end and save it, Command S, and find where my, it's getting a little confusing here. Here we go. So now I have a border. Now again, what's happened is the border, the padding is basically the background space that we're coloring. And we're giving it a background behind the, we're not actually doing border. If you'll notice, we're giving padding, which is empty space around the image, and then we're coloring that empty space. So notice this is tight up against. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna talk to the margin of this image. Now notice I only want the right. So if I'm floating images to the right, we'll need the margin left on the next one. But right now, this is gonna be margin right. So we're gonna free up space just on this right side of the image right here by saying margin dash right. So let me go ahead and do that. And again, I'm gonna hit the return key, add to the laundry list, margin dash right colon 20px. We can try that. I saved it, Command S, reloaded it. And sure enough, it pushes that paragraph off on the right-hand side of that image. So it kind of, you know, makes empty space and makes it better the way it lays out. So what we're going to do is we're going to float this one left. We just did. We're going to float this one right, do the same thing, except instead of margin right, we're going to say margin left on this one. So this is going to be floated right. The third one's going to be floated left. The fourth one's going to be floated right, and the fifth one's going to be floated left. Left, right, left, right, left, okay? So all we have to do is, remember, this one's called one. We already did that one. We're going to do it for number two, for three, and so forth, okay? And all we have to do is talk to that word. So I'm literally going to copy, highlight that, and copy it. And again, notice I'm still inside between the style tags. This is all that where the CSS goes. And instead of one, I'm going to make it two. Two. And also, instead of margin right, we're going to make it margin left. And I'm going to save it and reload it. Oh, and we forgot to change this to right. Here we go. Okay. My mistake. So there we go. So notice they look the same. There's empty space now here. Okay. Let's keep doing that. And I'm going to go like that. I'm going to change this to three. Okay. And then four, excuse me. And again, we're going to float right. And then margin left. And one more. We have one more. Hit the return key, drop the cursor down. And this is going to be 5. And, okay. And I saved it, go Command S. I'm going to reload my page. Okay. And now, you'll see that I have a fairly good looking page. Okay, with lots of text. Now, a couple things we could do that we'll do now. Excuse me. Let's put an HR in between the paragraphs. It's a little horizontal rule line, and it's just the tag HR. And all you have to do is go in between the paragraphs right here, and we're going to say HR. You don't have to close it. It's just one of those tags. You just have to do it once. Don't have to close it. Open and close it. And I'm going to highlight it, and I'm going to keep putting it just in between where two paragraphs meet. Not where the images and the paragraphs meet, but just between the paragraphs. I'm going to put an HR. And save it. Now, if I show you this, you'll see that there's that horizontal rule line. Let's stylize it, though. And I'm going to go in my CSS and talk to this tag. You go up here. And again, I'm in between the style tags. I'm going to say, hey, we have an HR, couple HR tags down there, and this is what we want to do. And so let's give it a width of some certain amount of percentage. Width, colon, let's say 40%, the percent sign, and a semicolon. And then let's give it a height of maybe 6px. And then we're going to give it a background color. Again, the word background. And I'm going to go, where is Chrome at? There we go. And let me see if I can use that. And I'll paste that hexadecimal color number, do the semicolon, save it. Reload it, and sure enough, I've stylized those HR tags. And it's a nice, easy, simple way to separate text on a page. You know, if your page is way too wordy, you have to figure out different ways with images or things like HR tags to kind of separate out that text. So, there you go. That's your kind of basic page. Remember, you want the images and the web page in the same location. Thanks.